Well, do we want to go into some autocorrect? What the Google autocorrect things? I was researching some of these autocorrect questions. Some of them we can go over. Some of them we don't need to go over.
Yeah. I'm actually curious. I've never done that because you type in like
and then pretty much we just kind of look at what fills Google in the blanks. Yes. Okay. It. So the first one is do the Dangy Bros have a sister?
Yeah. We have a full sister and then two half sisters.
Whoa, more canon.
So we do have sisters. Carrie, actually, my sister Carrie, my full sister, she actually worked for us for a little bit.
Oh, cool.
Okay.
So she helped out. I think she filmed for us and helped with social media.
Nice.
All right. That, okay. So. Next one up is do the Dangy Bros live in California?
Yes.
There we go.
That's easy enough.
Yeah. All right.
We're in Los Angeles.
Yes or no question right there.
All right. We're going to switch it to does, because that's another thing, too. Does Rob from Dangy Bros have a girlfriend?
As of right now, no. He's had two girlfriends while working for Dangy Bros, though.
Okay.
He recently just broke up with his last girlfriend, like 2 months ago.
I don't know. Oh,
which
snap.
We're not getting into that.
Oh, yeah. Man alive.
Right down the timestamp.
Internet. Got to write down the timestamp on that internet.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Like, I have a long
every line is, where does bleep?
Yeah, Robin. Does Jeff from Dangy Bros have a child?
Yes. I have a daughter. She is 14, almost 14 months old.
Whoa,
her name is Amelia.
How do you like being a father?
It's a beautiful name.
It's awesome.
Nice.
It's really awesome.
Yeah.
It's challenging at times.
Sure,
but it's,
right. Geez. A lot of sleepless nights, I'm betting. Like,
well, we actually have a great baby because there are some babies who are up all night. They have like colic or whatever. But she has been healthy since the day she was born. I mean, she's had like a cold once or twice.
Mm-hmm.
And then the teething. The teething actually has been the worst. Like a few months ago, she went through this like teething spell for like 2 or 3 weeks and she was miserable.
Ooh,
but like she still
screaming and
generally slept through the night. So, but from within the first month, we had like, it's a blessing from God that we got her sleeping through the night.
Right.
For the first, but within the first month. And like, so I have not lost much sleep. It's been great.
Really?
Yeah. Most parents, I've heard a lot of parents, they're up all night or whatever.
Right. Yeah. Well, that's good that you don't lose a lot of sleep. That's
We've been really. And Jillian's such a great mom, so she does great. She does. Yeah. Jillian is my wife.
Yes.
She does a great job. So.
All right. Cool. Well, that's
she's
a
great
sweet
mother.
Sweet that's little awesome. One. All right. Now the next one up is Dangy Bro Dog.
Oh, I hate dogs.
Tell us more.
Okay, I like dogs at a distance.
Right.
Let's hope that
wait.
Way.
Why is it? Why? I have a question.
Did a dog
show
up in multiple videos?
First off, why is Google asking
this?
Wait, what does it say?
Dangy Bro's dog.
That's it.
That's
but what's
it.
The question?
Weird.
That's the question.
So you would. So you just want?
Is there a dog that was on a video or something like that?
We've had. Zeke and Cody in the videos before.
Okay.
Those are two Pomeranian. Well, Cody's not yours.
Yeah, it's true.
We homed Cody.
I didn't know I had a celebrity as a dog.
Oh,
yeah. If you look in the 50 video games in real life, Cody's in that video.
Oh,
wow. We'll have to.
So,
okay.
We've had dogs. We've had dogs. So.
Right. Yeah. How many dogs do you have right now?
Now we have one. We had.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
What happened to
Tank?
Yeah.
He got rehomed. Yeah, so Tank, this is the... This is the
story. I like having a camera.
I'll tell you about Tank.
Oh,
this
yeah.
This is what happened.
Tank was your dog that I was not aware of.
Two parts of the story. One is the purpose of why we got him.
Mm-hmm.
And the second is me not enjoying having a dog. So the first half of it is we have a farm. We call it Jill's Goaty Coast. We got goats.
Oh, cool.
We have 7 goats. We have 26 chickens.
Wow.
4 ducks. And we live in a place where there's a lot of coyotes and mountain lions. So we're like, we'll get a livestock guardian. And that's one of the reasons we got a Great Pyrenees. Because I guess pure Great Pyrenees are very great protectors over that.
Sure.
You know, had went through the puppy stage. And then we found out that he might. So basically he gotten into the chicken pen. And like mauled some chickens.
Oh.
And so we're like, wait, why did they do that? And so Jillian, she went on her Facebook page where she has her animal stuff.
Yeah.
And like, was like, why would he do that? And some people think he has some golden retriever in him and they like hunt birds.
Oh,
and so
right.
We think
they retrieve them.
Yeah, we think that they're he's mixed, and we'll know, and it's going to be very difficult having him around birds because of that.
Right.
So that was half the reason we rehomed him, because we purposely got him for that reason, and now he no longer does that.
Sure.
The other half is I do not love having. I just don't enjoy owning a dog.
Yeah.
We got to make a sound bit out of that initially. You're like, I hate dogs.
I mean, I like them from a distance. Yeah. Like, if you have a dog, great. But I do not like taking care of dogs. It's not worth it for me.
Yeah.
And that's just my thing.
Right.
I just don't.
You have any cats?
I do have cats.
Okay.
I mean, we have three cats, and I wish we had one.
Okay. PSA to Jillian.
PSA. No, she already knows. Jillian already knows. Well, we got the two cats to be barn cats, but they're so small we don't want to let them out yet. So there's a day coming where they're going to be just outside.
Ex-native.
And I'm fine with that. I mean, the cats aren't bad. Like, I don't mind. I mean,
sure.
There's this one cat that keeps knocking over a vase. Like,
they just knock the same vase.
And so we've had to get like new vases. And like, we had this really nice vase with some plants in it, and he just knocked it off. I put two new ones on. I think he knocked off it again. And we're like,
oh no,
bro.
Right. Stop. What's up? What's up?
But I don't mind cats as much.
WT Frick.
Right. Right.
Right. Family friendly. Family friendly.
Yeah. So,
okay.
That's the story about dogs.
Right. Wow. Okay. Interesting. Interesting. I don't know if the internet knew that. But
I will say I'm open to having another dog, but it needs to be older.
Sure.
Like,
really? Okay.
The puppy stage drives me nuts.
Well, that's why we were so thankful when we got Cody, because he already went through that. Right. He was like perfect. It was like he came in trained, and we're like, oh.
Yeah, he's pretty decent.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Well, the next question, and we're not going to harp on this one too long because it's kind of creepy.
Oh, boy.
It's where, Dangy Bros? So where do the Dangy Bros live in California? And you don't have to answer these either.
I don't mind. I mean, here's my address. I'm just kidding.
Yep, bleep that one up.
No, this is what I'm willing to say. We live near Six Flags Magic Mountain.
Ooh, we're Six Flags. Near Six Flags.
And that's like, right outside of LA. And I mean, that's going to be pretty difficult to find me from that. So
right, yeah. Well, another one that the internet wants to know, not at all creepy at all, it's we're on what's now, right?
Mm-hmm.
What is the Danger Bros' last name? I'm already clicking the pen for a timestamp.
You have to blur my mouth too, because they're gonna.
Somebody's gonna really zoom in.
All right. Try to read.
Next one.
Wait, hold
next
on.
One.
The funny thing is, a lot of this information is available online.
I know.
So it's like,
whatever. Let's not. Well, you know, we'll still beep it for your own protection.
Yeah.
What is the Danger Bros phone number?
Oh, I've made this mistake. We had a punishment.
No, what?
We've had a punishment where we leaked my the punishment was to leak my phone number. It was awful.
Oh,
I had to get a new number.
Well, obviously.
Wait, so when you leaked it, what happened? Like, did
just immediately
people
just call phone calls? I got hundreds of text messages like right away. It was
bad.
Oh
my gosh. Oh my word, dude.
Yeah, I had to get a new phone number.
Oh,
that was bad.
That does sound pretty nasty. That's a nasty punishment.
I wish I would have known about silence unknown callers, because you can have that setting now.
Oh. Wow.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Interesting. I didn't know about that either.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So then another question that is kind of interesting is, what is the Danger Bros' least viewed video? And you probably even don't even know.
I don't.
Can we go to it?
Have my phone. Go to videos.
Is there a way to like go to...
I think...
Sort by?
No. Yeah, if you go to most popular and scroll all the way down.
Oh yeah, that's a good
the
one.
Actual zero of the bunch.
Oh yeah, let's go.
It is interesting. Like, have you found like a certain type really does well, and some just do not do well?
Yeah. I mean, we've definitely learned a lot about that. I mean, it's also just like the way you pull it off. Like, yeah, okay, dude, 206,000 views.
Wannabe KSI YouTuber.
Yeah, so when you guys know KSI, right?
Oh, yeah. Of course. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
When he started doing the whole YouTuber boxing, we just did like a parody, I guess, where we
were
cringy idiots.
No, maybe.
Certainly.
Well, I guess along those lines, what is your most popular video?
Ooh,
we can scroll. All the
I can
way
tell
to
you,
the top.
Tiny versus Giant, Unbreakable Box.
Ooh. Okay, yeah. What's
40,
that one?
What's over that? 40 million. 43 million.
43 mil views.
Yeah, that's crazy. And that short is at 38 million, which is pretty crazy.
Wow, pressing
too.
The YouTube buttons.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool.
I have no idea why that one did so well.
Interesting.
Don't know why.
Do you guys like track the analytics of like, okay, this one did well, and then trying to find why it did well?
Yeah, I mean, we do, but the thing is, analytics are also not It's just, I mean, it's so difficult to pinpoint exactly what it is. And right. also, like, because, like, it's people, it's easy to, like, focus on these numbers, but it's, like, people, you know? Right. It's, like, yeah. I think analytics are better used to, like, gauge how you're, I mean, obviously gauge how well you're doing, but, like, right. I don't think you can just, like, come up with, like, the perfect strategy and, like, implement it.
Right. Sure.
Unless you're, like, artificial sure. intelligence and you, like, use yeah. millions of videos and get, like, this huge database on, like,
right.
which
right.
they do, which is crazy.
Really?
I just went to VidSummit.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you were there.
Yeah.
And they were talking about how they have, like, AI, and they'll run their videos through
yeah.
it. And they can predict the watch time graph before it's even up. And I'm like, how is that possible?
What?
But they find that it's pretty, like, accurate.
It's crazy, dude.
How I'm is like, it AI. Accurate when it's...
It's because they're taking so many videos. And, like, I mean, that's the thing. I don't... Wow. I'm not even going to try to guess.
But, like, the thing is, though, is that, like, that's ceasing to become creativity. That's just, like, straight up straight numbers. I mean,
yeah,
surely...
and that's the problem with it. Like,
right.
It's like... The numbers are all great, but I mean, one thing that I think YouTube is doing, like, the direction YouTube is going well, it's like, let's focus on people, like, not numbers. And you can, because, like, Ryan Trahan, he's been talking a lot about, like, redemptive versus exploitative content.
Oh, yeah.
And, right. like, it is kind of exploitative, and we're guilty of it, you know?
Right.
Like, we just want to, how do we make this video, like, as entertaining as possible to keep them the entire time? And not that it's, like, necessarily, like, there's a balance, because, like,
yep.
it's entertainment. Like, obviously, you want them to enjoy it and watch the whole thing, but, like, you can approach it with a different heart and still get the same results,
yeah.
you know? So we're trying
right.
to, like, turn in that direction.
That's great.
That makes sense. Yeah. It makes a lot of sense. And I think it's smart, too, for, like, the community. And, like, doing that, though, I mean, from, like, an AI analytics perspective, it's not really been done. So then they're like, wait, that will be bad. But, like, what if it goes well? And then all of a sudden the analytics are like, because I think of, like, analytics as, like, right, they're trying to be predictive, but it's looking at historical data where it's like, well, I can be creative and then make
yeah.
more, you know.
Yeah, I literally listened to a podcast where Mr. B said, don't study analytics.
Oh, snap.
Like, he would rather you think about people and, like, the impact on them than, like,
sure.
study it. That's more valuable. I was like, wow. Dang.
Yeah. yeah. And Mr. Beast is pretty, he's pretty big.
Yeah. And I've been actually thinking about that for a while,
yeah.
you know.
Yeah.
And it's just interesting.
That's,
you know,
yeah,
it's interesting.
It's very interesting.
All right.
So
we can go to another question if you want to. Another auto-complete question. We're going to do Jeff from Dangy Bros.
Okay.
All right. So how old is Jeff from Dangy Bros?
24.
24?
Nothing else to it.
Pretty easy. Stock standard right there. When did you get into YouTube then? Right out of high school?
Well,
so 18?
When I first graduated, I must have been like 17.
Okay. So you've been doing YouTube for math.
Since I was 17.
Wait, 7 years.
What's math?
Yeah. Same.
Obviously,
right here.
I haven't been in school for a while. So.
7 years.
I graduated in 2015. Yeah, so
7 years.
About 7 years. Yeah.
Cool. Okay.
Wow.
Wow,
that's awesome.
Nice. Yeah. How tall is Jeff from the Danger Bros?
Ooh. I'm like 6'3".
Oh, very nice.
Ish.
Yes.
Ish. There's like a 3 and a, like
on a good
and
day.
Like a quarter or something like that.
Right. Right. Okay. All
oh,
right.
Yeah.
Acceptable. Acceptable.
Mm-hmm.
So is Jeff from Dangy Bros married?
Mm-hmm. I referenced Jillian earlier.
Right.
Yeah, we're married. Been married for over 2 years. Oh, wait,
over
June,
two.
July, August, September, October, November. 2 years and 5 months.
Nice.
So.
Very good. And you have a kid?
6 months-ish. Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah. Yeah, she's 14 months old, so.
Yeah, because that
got
kinda...
a fam going.
yeah.
Dangy fam.
yes.
So then,
next channel,
the next one, what is Jeff's phone number from the Dangy Bros, which obviously we don't need to go over again.
Creep.
Right, right. Leap that one out.
Just put, like, my numbers.
Dude, we don't need to do that. Why would we need to do that to ourselves?
I don't know.
Have all the...
if we lose some sort of chance.
yeah, sure. Is Jeff from Dangy... Well, this is dated probably. Is Jeff from Dangy Bros' wife pregnant?
No. Currently, no.
Currently, no.
No.
No. All right.
You never know in the next year or so. We might decide to try again. it's in the talks.
Oh,
you know?
Okay.
Okay. Cool. That's cool. Okay. Let's go to another one then. We can do why Dangy Bros?
Ooh.
Okay. I only get.
Uh-oh. Why is that? That's a question. Why
right,
is
now
a
he
little,
saw the question.
Little,
all right. All right.
A little sketchy.
All right. We're going to go through a couple easy ones, and then
we'll get
the one. I don't know if we've clickbait this as much. I'm looking into the camera. Do you see
how like, all about Michael, we I just know. Talked about.
No, I know. I don't want to clickbait it. First easy question is, are the Dangy Bros biological brothers?
Yeah, so
but
Jeffrey,
you should caveat it.
Chris
yeah.
and Robert are all brothers. Because people think Ryan is yeah. a brother. He is not. He's a friend.
Okay, but you guys are actually
biological brothers. Same mom, awesome. Same dad.
There yeah. we go.
Merry there Christmas.
Go. Merry Christmas. Yes. Happy New Year.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful.
All the conspiracies just go away there now.
Okay, then I guess, so the next question on the why is, are the Dangy Bros actually bros, which we just mm-hmm. went over again. And then, I don't know, should we ask this next? Okay, all right. Okay. All right, internet, you asked, why did Rob leave the Dangy Bros?
I have a better question. Why did our dad leave us when we were children?
Why did their dad leave us when they were children?
This takes it, runs.
Ladies and gentlemen.
No, I'm just kidding. It's funny because my dad did leave when I was like one.
Oh my
and
gosh.
Like, but I don't have like any emotional, like it never had emotion attached with him. So I've never, like, it's a joke. Like, it's kind of a joke to me. Like, I'll say that to surprise my friends.
You shouldn't be laughing.
I'm sorry.
No, you can laugh.
I
say it to surprise people. Because
it was shocking.
That shocked me.
It's such an
like
abrupt
when you ran with that though.
It's such an abrupt thing to say.
Yeah.
But like,
yeah!
I actually like don't care. I'm indifferent because I never knew him. And I also know things about him. Better. Maybe it's better that he wasn't.
Boom, boom, boom.
Oh, gosh.
All right, but the internet's still waiting.
Yeah,
okay. I wasn't trying to.
The internet.
That would have been a good segue. We could have gone to another topic.
Comments
here.
Are just like, he deflected. Yeah. He deflected.
No, okay, so I'm. How do I formulate this? So I would say primarily it's like, we're brothers, so it's it's family, mm-hmm. and you know there's challenges with working with your family. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know. I'm kind of drawing a blank here. Not gonna lie.
Well, yeah, I mean, like you know, I mean, family. It's always interesting to do stuff. Some people, you know, want to do other things and stuff mm-hmm. like that.
Well,
and
there's a few. Let me say a few.
There's no bad blood.
There's no blood. So Robert actually lives with me right now. We have him renting our room out. Relationship is great. There's no bad blood or anything like that. So what I would say is when we first started the channel, we're much younger, obviously. You get older over time.
Yep. Right.
Immature. There are immaturities that you need to grow out of, and we all had them, and it just made it – I'm not saying Robert was the immature. We all had immaturities, and, you know, there were – you know, and you're working with your siblings. Like,
yeah.
Think about that.
Yeah.
Anyone with siblings.
Yep.
Imagine working with your siblings.
Right.
And one thing that people don't know is that Robert was an employee of Dangy Bros. Chris and I co-owned it together.
Right.
And so, you know, there got to a point where Robert felt like he wanted to go. He wanted to leave.
Right. Which is fine.
That's personal family stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. We don't. So. Yeah. You don't,
no problem, guys. So quit asking. Okay.
Quit asking.
Chill. Yeah. It's okay. Yeah. All right.
Yeah, but, you know.
I don't want to yell at your fans. I don't know.
I don't know. It's a thing.
I'm sorry.
Looking at the camera.
Yeah.
Yeah. I apologize.
Yeah.
So, all right.
I mean, I don't know.
That's a good answer. I think that's a great answer. Jeff Dangy Bros' wedding. Is there a wedding that you guys had?
I had one.
You had one? Well, did you film it? Was that
We didn't film it. Chris filmed his.
Did he really?
Yeah, it's actually on the channel.
On the Dangy Bros?
Yeah, it was like right about COVID time, so we were like, we were struggling to upload a little bit.
Oh, sure.
We decided to post it.
Oh,
so
nice. Okay, cool. Has that been something that you've been working with, like post-COVID filming? Has that been a problem at all, or has that caused any issues?
It was at first because it was just so unknown, you know?
Sure.
But like, I'm like, who cares?
Right. Yeah.
They got to a point where, I mean, the nice thing about our business is that we hold it in our backyard.
Yeah, right.
I mean, it's now we used to live where we film, now we don't, but it's like, it's not like we're in public at a place, like we're able to, it's very isolated from normal businesses, so it's much easier for us to like handle things like that.
Right. So. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Quick question.
During COVID,
sorry.
I was just going to say, during COVID, did you guys like shut down for a little bit because of the
Well,
the uncertainty of like, oh, what, you know, because I know everyone was freaking out right around the right when, you know, COVID started and it was like a lot of places shut down and stuff. Yeah. So I was just curious what you guys did in that situation.
I don't really think we shut down. I think it was because like a lot of our videos, we like went to Home Depot to like buy stuff and like to like build things.
Right. Yeah.
And then like Home Depot was like weird. Like,
I
don't know if you guys remember, like if you guys felt the same way, but it just felt weird going outside.
Right.
It did. You know, you're just like, what's going on?
What
like,
happened?
If I go to Albertsons, am I going to like die?
Like I went to Cub once and like everyone was just like trying to, you know, stay away from each other and stuff. But there was this weird, it was this weird vibe. Like everyone's like trying to, well, the whole toilet paper thing where everyone was trying to just grab all the toilet paper. Like, and I went into Cub one time and there was like no cereal on any of the shelves.
Wow, really?
Like, they stole all the cereal. What is going on? Yeah, like there was like, I mean, there was a few of the nasty brands.
Oh, but like
that was it. All the good stuff was taken. I'm like, dang,
that's
like,
because those hoarders are running around and they're like, I want my Frosted Flakes, I want my Cinnamon Toast. And if I don't get it, I'm going to fall apart.
The fear of it all just kind of like,
right.
People did crazy things.
Right, yeah, fear. Yeah. Were you part of the toilet paper brigade? Did you, no? You weren't one of those?
I'm not a hoarder.
You're not a hoarder?
Like, Mike, was that what you're asking?
And they would hoard stuff. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. Like,
yeah.
No, I mean, that's ridiculous. I mean, do you realize how selfish that is to do that?
Oh, snap. Hitting them on the heartstrings.
There we go. I mean, it is. I mean, yeah, I'm going to go take all these products and then no one gets any.
Right.
You're so right.
Because I was looking for Frosted Flakes as well, and I couldn't find it.
And some people would hoard it.
Yeah.
Some people would hoard it and then try to resell at like an extremely high price.
Right.
And that's just like, that's...
It's messed up.
Yeah, and all I want to do is wipe my bum. Like, why do you gotta charge me like $18 for something like that, you know? I mean, goodness gracious.
Right.
Like, a man has needs that he, you know, you gotta, you know, there's...
Preach it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I will.
Yeah.
Anyways, on that note, we want to move on to another question. Speaking of pooping, are the Dangy Bros kid-friendly?
Yeah.
Why'd you say speaking of pooping?
I know. I got thrown off a little bit for a second.
I love that segue. You're like, oh, speaking of
kid-friendly.
Yeah, that's one. I mean, that's something we take pretty seriously, and it has to do with our faith. I see one.
We're getting to that. We're getting to that, too.
We'll stop there.
Yeah.
Chill. But so it's pretty important to us to be family friendly.
Right.
And
that's
want to honor the Lord with our channel. So.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Well, and you kind of referred to that too, how you took videos down from your previous channel as well.
Yep.
Let's go to that, I guess, too. I mean, there's two questions on here that they're asking, and I'll ask them both, and you can answer them. I mean, first one is, are the Dangy Bros Mormon? And then the second one is, are the Dangy Bros Christian?
We are not Mormon.
There you go. You heard that here.
We're not. And I could tell you why. But yeah, we are Christian. So
nice.
Yeah.
That's very good.
Chris and I have been, we started, I think it's about 7 years. We both kind of started going to church and walking with the Lord about the same time.
Very cool.
So probably about 6 or 7 years ish.
Wow.
So